ready for action. Playing against the Ahrens family. Lisa, Susie, Barry, Macbeth, and Kate, on your mark. Let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Ray Cohn.
Oh, 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 oh. Oh, oh, oh. Thank you. Thank you, my friend. Merry Christmas. Oh, oh, oh. Welcome to Family Feud. Thank you for joining us at home. I'm Santa Ray, returning as champions. The Hillard Family.
Hi, Santa.
How are you, David?
Good, Santa. Good.
It's a pleasure for you to be here on one of our very special Christmas shows. Now, your family so far has 6,785.
All right, David. Loving it. Thank you.
You have something to put in the stockings? Who'd you bring to help you become champs once again?
Well, Ray, I brought my four beautiful sisters. My sister, Jeannie.
Hi, Santa.
Hi, Jeannie. How would you like to sit on Santa's lap?
I'd like
to. Okay, never mind.
My sister, Patty.
Hi, Patty.
Santa. Hi. My sister Sarah.
Hi, Santa.
Good to see you again.
Thank you.
And my sister Donna.
Hi, Santa.
Donna.
Hi,
nice
Santa.
To see you again.
And now, let's meet your opponents, the Ahrens. Give them a big hand. Macbeth.
Hi.
Am I saying that right, Ahrens?
Perfect.
Now, do you really believe it's me, or do you think it's Ray Combs?
I hope you have a lot for us.
Oh, really? Well, we can talk about it. Have you been
okay.
a good girl?
Always.
You have been a good girl.
Yeah.
Well, then there's probably not a lot for you from me. Okay, now, Macbeth, who'd you bring to help you become champs?
I brought the best husband in the world, Barry.
Well, there you go. Hi, Barry.
And my beautiful sister, Kate.
Hi, Kate.
And our wonderful cousin, Susie.
Yeah, that's her name, Susie.
Hi.
You wouldn't be lying about these relatives, would you?
And Susie's sister, Lisa.
Hi, everybody. I wish you a lot of luck.
There's only one way for Santa to give you that big bucks, and that's to play the feud. Let's go, Hillard. Santa's a little shaken up here. He can't see.
Hi,
Beth, David. The first family to $300 will win the game, get a chance to play fast money for the $5,000. Good luck to both. Are you ready, Macbeth?
Yeah, I'm ready.
All right. We asked 100 people this question. We've got the top four answers on the board. Try to find the most popular.
Name something you find in your Christmas stocking.
Macbeth.
Orange.
She said an orange right at the buzzer. The judge says, okay, show me orange. Number two, one answer gives you control, David.
Candy cane.
Let me see. Candy canes. Oh, oh, oh. Number one answer. Candy, right there we go. Howdy, Jeannie.
Hi.
It's a pleasure to have Santa to have you on his show. Name something you find in your Christmas stocking.
Can I say some sort of toy?
The judge, can she say some sort of toy? You can
I'm going to say a toy.
A toy.
Okay.
All right.
Okay.
Show us a toy. Whoa. First strike. Patty?
I'll say socks.
Socks.
Good answer. Good answer, Patty.
Wrap those up.
Good, Patty. That's good.
Santa Claus has put socks in your stocking?
I put them in my husband's stocking.
You put socks in? What, for what reason do you do that?
Well, too little to wrap up.
Socks are good stocking stuff.
Yeah. Socks.
All right. Okay, Patty. We'll see if it's there.
Okay.
Show us socks. All right.
Okay.
Two strikes, two answers left, Sarah.
How about cologne or perfume?
Oh, I like
good.
That. I'd like to get some
like
of that.
Me
nice
too.
Stuff. Perhaps to stay alive, cologne. Yeah, perfume. Donna, one answer, and you got the bank first.
How about gum?
Gum.
Yeah.
If it's there, Santa gives you the bank first, and we're on our way. Show us gum. That's the third strike. Ahrens, you can steal. Here we go. Name something you find in your Christmas stocking, please.
Handkerchief.
A handkerchief. Susie?
Money.
Woo, money.
Nuts.
What?
Nuts.
Okay, all right. Barry?
Nuts.
Nuts. A couple people say nuts. Macbeth, you could take any of those answers. Go out on your own. But if you can give me number three, you got the bank.
Oh, nuts.
Are you saying that as the answer, or are you saying it because you're frustrated? That's the answer. All right. If it's there, you got the bank. If not, the Hilliards. Let me see nuts. Not there. Hilliards take that bank.
There's an answer that we didn't know about Christmas stockings. Show us number three. The feud's begun, and I promise you there's a lot more fun. This is a very special show, so don't go away. Welcome back to Family Feud. It's the reverse Santa Claus werewolf syndrome. I'm losing my hair. I'm going back to Ray Combs. $82 for the Hilliards. The Arum Zero. Let's go. It's time for another face-off. Barry.
Hey, Barry.
Jeannie, we've got the top six answers on the board. You can put your hand right up there.
Okay,
Jeannie, you're a lovely gal. Name a kind of food that gets stuck between your teeth. Barry?
Peanut butter.
Let me see peanut butter. It's on the survey, but five answers will beat it.
Popcorn or popcorn husks?
You're so good at this. Popcorn husks? It is there, number three, back with your family. See, now, you are so honest, Jeannie. People who didn't tune in the show yesterday didn't get to see the splendor.
Oh, don't say it.
I won't
say
it. I will not bring up the fact
okay,
that in Fast, I won't do it. Because if you don't want me to, I won't. In Fast Money, when I asked the question, something of a woman looks in the mirror and catches on her face in a date that would embarrass her, and you said, Booger, I'm not going to say it, Jeannie. I won't say it if it will embarrass you. But that wasn't what I was
going to say. That would be embarrassing, though, wouldn't it?
But that would be, but it never happened to me. But the question that you didn't talk about was I asked, name the color of M&Ms that you would eat first. And you said you wouldn't eat green ones. You said you wouldn't eat green, and I asked you why, and you said the reason was, why don't you eat green M&Ms?
Not me personally. I just know you pull a lot of people. And
you pull a lot of people, what?
You pull a lot of people. It's been said that the green ones make you the big H.
What's the big H? What's the big H?
Horny.
If you have found some kind of a scientific breakthrough, you should share it with the world. And if it's green M&Ms, you can make a lot of people happy in their relationship.
Let's see.
You know, all the times I was a kid younger, I would have been slipping green M&Ms in my girlfriend's M&Ms. You know, she would have been saying, these are all green. Well, just eat them, honey. You'll feel better. Okay, Jeannie. Thank you. Thank you very much. Patty, name a kind of food that gets stuck between your teeth.
Pepper.
All right, show us. Pepper. Oh, didn't make our survey. Only one strike, Sarah.
Hi, Ray.
Hi.
Corn on the cob.
Let me see. I hate that. Get stuck right there.
Yeah.
Corn on the cob. Number one. Donna.
Hi, Ray.
Hi.
Hi. I'm going to say licorice.
Yeah. Which flavor?
Red. I like red.
Show us some licorice. Green. Oh, two strikes. David?
Stuck between your teeth?
Yes.
I'll go with... potato chips.
They do get stuck between there. If it's there, you're still alive. Show me some potato chips. Didn't make our survey third strike, Aaron. Can you steal? Name a kind of food that gets stuck between your teeth. Lisa.
I'm going to say nuts.
Nuts.
Chicken.
Chicken.
Broccoli.
Broccoli.
Gum.
Gum. Oh, a lot of different answers, Macbeth. What you going to go with?
Sesame seeds. Seeds.
Did anybody say sesame seeds?
Seeds.
You go out on your own. You are a leader. If it's there, you got the bank. If not, the champions. Show us sesame seeds. Not fair, Hilliard. You've got the bag. Don't feel bad. Maybe your teammates didn't have the right answer either. If they didn't, you're not so bad. Number two, meat or poultry. Number four, caramel. Number five, nuts. Who said nuts and chicken? All right, anything can happen. We're coming right back, but for sure somebody's going to play for $5,000. Don't miss it. Welcome back to the Feud. Right now, the Hilliards have $144 in a big lead over the Arums, zero. Let's go, Kate. It's time for another face. Patty? Good luck. The dollar value is doubled for this question. Now, Kate, you need to come alive for your family to get into the game. We've got the top six answers on the board. Name something children remember riding on for the first time. Patty?
A bike.
Okay, perhaps a bicycle. It's number one. You're going to steal if you get the chance. Really important.
Good. Yeah, good job.
Sarah, the lovely Sarah.
Hi, Ray.
How are you doing?
Fine, thank you.
Now, you lovely gals have been so sweet on the shows if you've been here before. You got bubbly personalities.
We're excited.
Now, your sister Jeannie has given us some revelations. Were you aware of her breakthrough knowledge of these green M&Ms?
Just spontaneous.
Did she share that with you about the M&Ms? Did you know that before today?
No, I never heard that before in my life.
Come on.
She may have M&M's baby selling like crazy these days.
Oh, how many children do you have, Jeannie? One and one. And how many children do you have?
Three.
Three. And how many do you have, Patty?
Three girls.
Three. And how many do you have, Donna?
Four.
A lot of M&Ms being eaten in this family, I would say that. A family of nine. So your mother probably passed this secret on to you. All right, Sarah.
Okay.
Name, since you have children, you would know this. Name something that children remember riding on for the very first time.
I think a pony.
Good.
Yeah.
Pony ride. Good.
Let's see. I would remember that.
I think so, yeah.
Show me a pony. Yay! A horse is a pony. Yeah. Donna?
Hi, Ray.
How you doing?
Good, good.
Okay. Now, name something children remember riding on for the first time.
Well, I have sons, so how about a skateboard?
Yeah.
All right. Mm-hmm. Didn't have those when you were a kid, huh? No skateboards for you?
I don't like skateboards. My children love them.
But you've never ridden on one?
I have never ridden on a skateboard.
Okay. Show us a skateboard.
Okay.
They've perfected them now. They're all different. David, you have no children.
No, not yet.
Because you're not murdered? Married?
I'm married.
You are married?
Yeah.
Okay. Name something children remember riding on for the first time.
I'll say a rocking horse.
Yeah, that's an awfully exciting thing. Do you remember the first time you rode on one? Try to think back. Be honest. Don't lie if you don't.
I remember riding on one. Not the first time.
I remember, too. I was 14. It was an exciting thing for me. My father put me on.
Two quarters, huh?
That's right. Show me a rocking horse. Now, that's two strikes. Now, Jeannie, you would know this. You got to give me that number three answer to stay alive.
God, there's a lot. Maybe a train would be up there. First time they rode on a train.
Yay!
Have you taken your kids on a train?
We almost did this weekend.
You almost did?
She's only two, but I plan to.
You're going to?
I was on a train, and I remember the first time I moved to California on a train.
All right, tell me a little bit about that very quickly, because talking to you is like talking to a person that... I feel like whatever you say, you're hearing it for the first time when it comes out too sometimes, Jenny. So tell me, what do you remember most about the first time you went on a train?
I remember that we were on our way to California, and I had a lot of peanut butter and jelly sandwiches from the porter.
Yeah? Did you ever, at any point...
We remember that.
You remember that?
Yeah.
How old were you?
I was five.
You remember that?
I remember it vividly.
We moved from Michigan to California on a train.
All right, well, thank you. I know all of America is fascinated by this, but, Jeannie, thank you for sharing your childhood. You say a train. Show me, to stay alive, a train. It's there!
Yay!
I super said it. Lovely Patty.
Yes. Yeah.
All right, you can't say train because she already said it. Something children remember riding on for the first time.
Airplane.
Good.
Right, good.
Gotta be there. I remember that. Show me airplane. Number three. Coming alive again.
Okay.
Okay, now they've taken probably some of your great answers, but you know what that number four answer is.
What I've been having in my mind is a carousel. You know, at a park, an amusement park.
Well, kids, the merry-go-round.
Yeah.
Kids do love it. It's got to be there. If it's not, though, they're going for the steal.
Okay.
Show me a merry-go-round. Hey! Donna, I don't want to put any pressure on you, but it comes down to this question. You have two strikes, and you have one answer there. You give me the answer, you're playing for $5,000. If not, they're going for the steal.
I might have it. Your father's back, like piggyback.
Your father's back?
Yes, riding on your father's back.
You remember that?
Yes. Piggyback on the floor.
Yeah. It's good.
Okay. It is a good one. Yeah. If your father's back is there, you're the champions and you're playing for $5,000. Show me your father's back. All right, now we can see if the errands can steal. What is number five? Name something children remember riding on for the first time, Lisa.
Sled.
A sled. Susie.
Sled.
A sled. Katie.
Amusement ride.
Amusement ride. Barry.
Roller coaster.
Roller coaster. What's it going to be, Macbeth?
Oh,
you can take any of those answers. Name
a
something.
A roller coaster.
A roller coaster?
No.
All right. If roller coaster is there, you win the game. Or no, if roller coaster is there, you take the bank. If not, the Hilliards win the game. Is number five a roller coaster? It is! $172 for the errands. The Hilliards 144. Let's go. Time for another face-off. Here we go. We've got... Macbeth, would you please go back in your place? Macbeth is all excited. Susie, Sarah?
I know, they call me.
The dollar value is tripled. We've got the top four answers on the board. Name a musical instrument more often played by girls than by boys. Sarah?
A flute.
Let me see, a flute? It's number one. Back at your phone, Susie. Musical instrument more often played by girls than boys, Donna?
Piano.
Show me. Piano. Number two, David.
Okay. A heart.
Perhaps.
A heart.
Good.
Number three.
Very good.
Jeannie, bring it home.
Violin.
My girlfriend Jeannie says violin, and if it's there, you're playing for $5,000. Show me violin. Say they came out, got you at the end there. You played really good. Thank you for being on the show. We got some nice party here. Thanks a lot, you guys. You're great. I need two players. $5,000. Let's go, David, off stage. Jeannie with me. Here we go. The Hilliards playing Fast Money for $5,000 right after these messages. Welcome back to Family Feud. About to play Fast Money for $5,000 with the Hilliards. Are you ready?
I think so, right?
15 seconds on the clock, please. Good luck, Jeannie. Look straight ahead. Tell me how fast you drive in a 55-mile-per-hour zone.
60.
A city with a symphony orchestra.
New York City.
A vegetable you eat with your fingers.
Broccoli.
Something you buy a pint of.
A pint of sour cream.
Something you use lemon in.
Iced tea.
Turn around here. Stay right here beside Santa. Tell me how fast you drive in a 55-mile-per-hour zone, you said? 60 miles an hour. Our survey said 50. Wow. A city with a symphony orchestra, you said? New York. Our survey said 27. A vegetable you eat with your fingers, you said? Broccoli. Our survey said none. Something you buy a pint of. Your choice? A pint of sour cream. Our survey said zero. Something you use lemon in, you said? Let's see if this takes you over 100. Our survey said 50. 128. Back with your family. There you go. Here comes your brother David. Come on, David. My friend, you need 72 points for the 5,000. Look straight ahead. 20 seconds on the clock, please. Revealing your partner's answers. Come on, you can do this. Tell me how fast you drive in a 55-mile-per-hour zone.
60.
Try again.
65.
A city with a symphony orchestra.
Boston.
A vegetable you eat with your fingers.
Corn on the cob.
Something you buy a pint of.
Bourbon.
Something you use lemon in.
Iced tea.
Try again.
Lemonade.
Turn around, baby. Boy, you gave some great answers. Tell me how fast you drive in a 55-mile-per-hour zone. Your choice? 65 miles an hour. Our survey said 10. 60 was the number one answer. City for the symphony orchestra, you said? Boston. Our survey said 32. Boston, the number one answer. A vegetable you eat with your fingers, you said? Corn on the cob. Our survey said
43.
Coming right back. Don't go away.
Thanks a lot. You're trying to rush down. Thank you.
All right.
The first time I...
Welcome back to Family Feud. If you've just tuned in, the Hillier family have won the game. They're the champions once again. They got $12,202. There's a couple of answers that were number one I want to tell you. A vegetable you eat with your fingers. Corn on the cob, number one answer. Something you buy a pint of. Whiskey, number one answer. Something you use a lemon in. Iced tea was the number one answer. Now, this is a special time. It's Christmas time. And we have the Hillier family here. But I want to introduce my family. I've got them all here. And we're getting bigger every year. Look at this. This. It's my daughter, Chelsea. You know her from the baby rap commercial. Give me a little baby rap. Baby rap. This is Chelsea. This is the baby right here. This is Kirby. This is Kirby. Little Kirby. I don't know if we can get a shot of this right here. She looks like her dad. She's awful cute. We got the same dress. This is my daughter, Whitney, right here. Whitney, yeah, take a look right there. Say hi. This is Kelly. Kelly, give him that smile. Show him what you got. And this is my son, Ray. His head doubles for an airport right there. And look at Chelsea. Give him a clap one more time. And the star of Family Feud, Ray Combs. No, see, she claps just like that. Oh, hold on. Here, hold on to this right here. We appreciate your family joining our family this year. And from all of us here, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Some of our departments. From Television City in Hollywood, this is Gene Woods speaking for Family Feud, a Mark Goodson television production.